As a dry eye specialist, I have never been more excited about new therapies for the lids and ocular surface as I have been in the last year. One of the most exciting new categories to emerge in dry eye care is that of light therapies for dry eye syndrome, namely intense pulse light, IPL, and LLLT, or low-level light therapy photobiomodulation. In today's video, I'll quickly recap each of them and compare and contrast the therapies. Welcome to Eye School with Dr. D, where my goal is to arm you with the knowledge you need to take control of your eye health and have the best vision possible. Like and subscribe for videos every week. Eye School is in session, and today we're covering one of my favorite dry eye therapy categories, light therapy. This channel is all about eye education, especially in the realm of ocular aesthetics and dry eye syndrome. And if you found this video because you were searching for information on dry eye, I'll leave a playlist right here on dry eye and blepharitis for you to check out. So what is light therapy and why would we use it? Well, light therapies in the realm of dry eye care are mostly aimed at treating disorders of the eyelids and meibomian glands. Light therapies have been shown to kill Demodex mites, improve the secretion of the meibomian glands, reduce ocular surface inflammation, and reduce the inflammatory effects of rosacea. They can rejuvenate the meibomian glands and are very effective at improving the signs and symptoms of dry eye disease. Let's talk about the types of light therapies to help you choose the one that's best for you. So first we have intense pulse light. Luminous received FDA clearance for their OptiLight device earlier this year in 2021. Intense pulse light has been used for over 20 years with over 50 studies demonstrating its efficacy in dry eye disease. IPL targets pigment, so it is very effective in patients with rosacea at decreasing the amount of telangiectasias or extra blood vessels present on their skin. We know that the presence of ocular surface inflammation increases with increased, what I call telangiectasias, or little those broken blood vessels on the face. By treating the face for these abnormal blood vessels, ocular surface inflammation is decreased. In addition, IPL changes the secretion of the meibomian glands and even rejuvenates glands that have begun to atrophy. It decreases the population of Demodex mites, and I'll link my favorite YouTube video of all time above that shows IPL killing a Demodex mite by Dr. Laura Perryman. After IPL, tear breakup has been shown to increase and symptom scores improve. I made a video about what to expect with IPL treatment that I'll link above here. If you have the opportunity to try IPL for your dry eye, I would highly recommend it. Now, another type of light therapy is called photobiomodulation. This is another light therapy that has been gaining clinical popularity, and it's also called LLLT or LED light therapy. LED light has been extensively studied in skincare and has anti-inflammatory benefits for skin in rosacea and other inflammatory skin conditions. The idea behind photobiomodulation is to use light to affect change in a tissue. At the right wavelength and for the right period of time, we're looking to repair damaged cells and improve cellular function. Photobiomodulation is aimed to reduce inflammation, promote wound healing, and treat pain and neurological disorders. We don't know the exact mechanism of how photobiomodulation works, but we know that mitochondrial chromophores absorb red and near-infrared wavelengths. And so the mitochondria, as that powerhouse of the cell, are likely the initiation site for what happens next in the cell. We essentially know that LED lights at specific wavelengths stimulate ATP production in the meibomian glands, and that leads to endogenous heating, thus promoting thinner oil flow, better flow of the oil from the glands. Photobiomodulation is thought to heat the glands and help the body produce better oil, but it does not kill Demodex mites or affect inflammation at the ocular surface in the same way that IPL does. So I personally have both therapies available to my patients in my clinic. The more options, the better. And for a myriad of reasons, one therapy might make more sense to one of my patients at any given time. Have you tried IPL or photobiomodulation? What was your experience? Make sure to share down below in the comments. I love hearing from you guys. So that's going to be it for today's iSchool. I will see you next time. Class is dismissed.